About lunchtime, we were sitting outside because it was very hot, and my late husband now suggested that I go up to the phone box to see if there was still a school bus. My eldest son Ian started high school that day, and there was a bus, but that's from then on that everything was a bit hectic. And I was sitting inside putting elastic on, not elastic, loops on my son's, that son's trousers to bring for a belt the day of the fire. And I had on a dollar shift, and my Rodney was four. He had a little piece of bathers. I don't know, late in the afternoon I decided I'd put the clothes away. In my husband worked night clothes. And I decided I'd put the clothes away in that room, something I've never done. So I've considered now, thinking it over, that I actually saved our lives. Because when he got up and saw how bad it was, we went in the car. That's the start of that day. And we went up to the Glebe. My husband's parents lived up on the Glebe. We went up there for the night, and then we went to live with my mother in Marine Terrace. And then we finally, my brother in Belrive, we rented a house from him until August, I think it was, when the house was rebuilt. It's funny, I shouldn't say it, but my mother-in-law lent me a pair of slippers and a cardigan and said when I finished with them, would I give them back to them. I didn't have any shoes on, I had, as I say. I was 7 months pregnant with my son Michael, who was born 6 weeks after, and he had the RH problem, so he could have died as well. So 1967 was a year I'll never forget.